Hi, Alec here from Platformly. In this tutorial video, we're going to explain the sales CRM options within our automations builder. So as you know, everything starts from the triggers, so we're gonna start from there too. If we click here in the drop-down, we can just search quickly for deal and we can see all the options that are available. Everywhere, so in the conditions, in the global condition, in the actions also. So as you can see, we have three options. I'm gonna just quickly add them all and explain them. Okay, so deal stage changed. So if specific deal is moved from stage A to stage B, so in this case, you need just to choose a pipeline, and if it was in lead and now it's moved to qualified, then that contact, if this one contact is moved, it's added to this automation. It basically fires the trigger. If specific deal has two or three contacts, so multiple contacts, and it is moved to a different stage, all those contacts will be added to this automation too. So it depends how many contacts a deal has. By default, it's mostly one, but if it is two or three or even five, they're all gonna come in this automation. So that's quite important to understand. Then we have deal status change, basically behaves similar like stage. It's a pipeline. And so here you can choose between open, won, or lost status. So if a deal status changes from open to won or to lost, or even if it is won, then reopen. So if it is open, meaning some deal went to lost and then it's reopened, then this automation is starting for that specific contact in that deal. And one more is the enters a deal pipeline. So this means when, so you just choose a pipeline here. This means basically when you create a new deal, you assign a contact to a deal, one or multiple, and you choose a pipeline there and you save it, then it triggers this trigger, it fires this trigger. So if there is, again, one contact, it will come to automation. If there's multiple contacts, all of them will come in the actual automation. Let's move further now down the road. Quickly, I'm gonna just, I can add a period delay, for example, 0 minutes. Let me just reduce my zoom a little bit because there will be a lot of objects coming up. And we can now see the conditions. So if we choose a fork, so these conditions are available here, but also in the global conditions. So again, in the dropdown, you just search for deal and you're able to see all the options. So you can use the deal conditions globally, but also in the actual automation locally. So quickly, if we're gonna search, I'm gonna also again. So you have has deal in stage. So again, it's the similar approach as in triggers. You select a pipeline and you choose a stage. And basically it checks if the contact has a deal in stage qualified within default pipeline. Then we have the another one is status, where you choose the pipeline. So if the contact has deal, at least one, that is with open in the status in the default pipeline, then it goes to yes node. Then we have has deal with value. This is interesting, for example. So you can say if it is less than 500 bucks, do this, for example, if here is 500. Then you can say if it is greater than 500 or if it is equal to. So it gives you a full flexibility there. And as last, it also can check the total number of deals. So let's say, for example, we can go with open. And less than equal greater. Okay, so let's say if he has greater than five open deals, it means that this contact for us is basically not anymore interesting. So we can do some specific actions on it, etc. So as you can see, yeah, full flexibility there. So select greater than 500 in this case. Okay, so these are the options in the fork, and also, as I said, they are available in the global conditions. And now let's go on the yes note and start with the actions. So we have two types actions regarding the sales CRM. One are for deals and the others are for activity. So we have, I'm gonna enter them all on the board and I'm gonna explain them one by one. So let's go with deal. So you just type in deal as in previous examples and you can choose the options. So we go with add a deal, then update deal field value, then change deal status, add a note, stage, yep. And activity 1 are add a deal activity and mark as done a deal activity. Okay, so let's browse them one by one and explain the options quickly. So this one is quite powerful, so add a deal and also add a deal activity. So when something happens and some conditions are fulfilled, for example, you can add a specific deal. So you choose the pipeline where you want a deal to go. You choose the stage, so in this case it can be lead, or maybe it is already you want to move him to contact because he did some specific. You enter deal title, choose its value, 500, and then you assign it. You can either assign it to a specific team member or leave it assigned to the entire company. Okay, then you can update the field's value. So here you choose the pipeline where the deal basically is. And this is an important selector, which should be understood properly. So here you can choose between most recent deal for this contact. Okay, so if we select this, that means that the latest deal that this contact has then equal to 800, or let's say increase it by 800. So what this is gonna do is gonna get the contact's latest deal in this pipeline and increase its value by 800. But we have more options here, because we figured out that it's important to have them there. So all deals for this contact, so you can basically execute this action by increase by 800 to all deals, or you can just say, okay, all open deals, all won deals, or all lost deals. This selector is also available in some other actions, and it's important part of the selecting. Mostly, in most cases, this one will be used, like most recent deal for this contact, but you have the flexibility also to do other selecting here. Okay, so let's say, for example, we go down, change deal status. So again, you can choose the pipeline, you choose what status, and the deal selector. So you can choose the most recent one that you added. So if we do it like this, basically we just added a deal, which is default pipeline stage title deal title 500, okay? So if I choose most recent deal for this stage and I choose one, then this deal basically that we just created in the flow of this automation, its status is gonna be changed to one, okay? But if you want from some reason to close all other deals and just leave this one open, we can say, okay, move all deals, all open deals for this contact. Then we go next to add a note. So if we go here, you can see the options are quite similar. So you choose a pipeline, you choose what kind of note, or deal selector, sorry, and then you type in the note. So you can say, okay, to all open, all won, or lost deals. Okay, so let's see if we have some lost deals with this guy or all open them, we can just type a note, specific note. Then the deal stage is similar to the status stage, just a pipeline choosing specific stage. So if we created this deal, okay, and if we want to change that stage deal from some reason, then we can come here and we can just select a stage and we choose most recent deal for this contact, and we go with this, we're basically changing this deal stage. Okay, and the last actions are for the activity, which is also important part from the automations, because you can easily add a deal activity to the newest deal that you created, to the latest deal. Maybe it was created before, doesn't need to be created in this automation, of course. You have the same selector where you can choose so more recent deal for this contact, all deals, all open, or won, or lost, etc. You enter activity title, then description, you choose the pipeline, affected pipeline, then you can choose what kind of activity it is, so meeting, task, email, deal selector on my most recent one, let's say 3 days, assign it to this team member. And let's see if we just move them this like that. I'll show you why. Like this. Okay. So that. Okay. Here you want to go. Okay. Go like that. So here Mark has done a deal activity. We're gonna choose a pipeline. Let's say most recent and all deal activities. Okay, so what we did here, what we did is basically on the most recent deal in this pipeline, on the most recent deal, we just closed all deal activities, so they're done, or okay, they're finished, and now we opened a new one. Okay, we just closed all of them and just opened a new one. I know that landing them like this, the options, it's a little bit maybe confusing, but there is a lot of possibilities, and based on the needs, it is really really fully flexible to be used. As example, if I'm gonna just, let me clean this one, and this one, for example, okay, and this one, this, okay. So as you can see here, we're gonna just change this one to most recent one. So let me explain what this automation does. So when a specific trigger happens, so in this case it's in the same pipeline, but we should, of course, the trigger should be in different pipelines. So when a specific trigger happens, fulfill some specific conditions, then we add a deal, then we add a note to the most recent deal, so we are adding a note to this deal, and we are creating an activity to the this pipeline and most recent deal for this activity. So if we even remove this, this, for example, that, okay, like this, and we can even, so for example, we remove the pipeline stuff. This was just for explaining here. So let's say, you know, segment, whatever, some specific segment, test project, okay, test segment. So if a user was added to segment, test segment, create a deal for him, add a note to that deal, and create a deal activity and assign it to Igor. So quite easy, boom, 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 it creates everything it needs. So I hope it is clear how powerful this is and how the options can be used within the automation. So the possibilities are basically endless. You can do different kind of options, combine them with segments, with other triggers, so other conditions that we already have, and do very, quite powerful automations. Thanks for watching the video, and any questions, we are here to respond.